Welcome back, friends. Today we are going to continue with our topic of coordination. And today we are going to have a discussion on the mechanism of transduction and the properties of receptors. So starting with the mechanism of transduction, as we said that the function of receptors, they tend to receive the stimulus from environment and they transduce it. So they change the nerve impulse. They change the stimulus either from the environment or the internal stimulus into the nerve impulse. So transduction is the name given to the process by which a receptor converts a stimulus into the nerve impulse. Conversion from stimulus to the nerve impulse is called the transduction. Now the stimulus may be light, it may be electricity, it may be touch, or etc. as shown in the table above. Here we have the table which show different types of stimulus. For example, in type of receptor, we have the photoreceptor which receives a light, and we have electricity, sound, touch, pressure, gravity, temperature change, humidity, smell. All of these are different categories of stimulus. From the environment, we may have different categories of stimulus. And then in this part now, we are looking how these different categories of stimulus zinakuwa converted kwenda kwenye nerve impulse. But the nerve impulse is always the same in nature, which is electrical in nature. And the way it travels in the axon is always through the action potential. So all sensory cells, they are excitable cells, and they share with the nerve cells and the muscle cells the ability to respond to an appropriate stimulus by producing a rapid change in the electrical properties. So sensory cells are excitable, pamoja na nerve cell ni excitable, and the muscle cell they excitable. If we reach at university, we'll read about the excitable tissues, in which you read about the nerve cells and the muscle cells, the skeletal muscle, and the cardiac muscle cells, how are they stimulated and how they develop the action potential. So when not stimulated, sensory cells are able to maintain a resting potential, which we discussed in previous sessions regarding the resting potential, and the charge inside the neuron is negative with respect to outside. We discussed about the resting potential, and we saw how the resting potential can be maintained in the neuron or the nerve cell. So they respond to a stimulus by producing a change in the membrane potential. So when they receive stimulus, or when they are stimulated, they produce a change in the membrane potential. Bernard Kaz in 1950, using a specialized stretch receptor known as muscle spindle, was able to demonstrate the presence of depolarization in the immediate region of sensory nerve ending in the muscle spindle. This localized depolarization is found only in the sensory cells and is known as generator potential. Kwa hiyo aliona depolarization, loss of charge, ile namna ya ndani kuwa negative ilianza kupungua, unaona, aliona slight depolarization. Subsequent investigation involved intracellular recording made by penetrating the membranes of receptor cell in the muscle spindle and the mechanoreceptor of skin in the Pacinian corpuscle have revealed the following information about transduction. Kwa hiyo, regarding the mechanism of transduction and all the information about the generator potential, they are summarized in these few points here. First is that the generator potential results from the stimulus producing an increase in the permeability of the sensory cell. If you remember, in part of resting and action potential, we said the slightly depolarization caused by the stimulus will cause the increase in the permeability of sodium ions, and thus will cause the sodium ions to rush into the cell, thus causing depolarization. Or in other words, we can say that the negative charge inside the axon, it will decrease due to the entry of the sodium ions. So the generator potential results from the stimulus producing an increase in the permeability of sensory cell membrane to sodium and potassium ions, which flow down the electrochemical gradient. might be you don't understand about the genital potential, and actually you never heard about the term genital potential. Now let me explain to you genital potential a little bit before I continue with my discussion regarding a mechanism of transduction. What is genital potential? Now assume we have the graph plotted here, and in this graph, let's assume this is the graph of action potential, like what we discussed in the part of action and resting potential. If you remember, we had a graph of this fashion. We said if here is the resting potential, then this can, in the opening of sodium ion channels, we will have the raising phase of this graph, and then this graph later will fall after the development of action potential to hyperrepolarization, and then it will come back again to its original state. Now, to navozungumzia generator potential manake nini? Here the negative 40, upper negative 40. Na hapa chini ni hapa ni positive 40. Hapa chini negative 70. Sasa kunaweza kukaa kuna potential kwenye membrane ambayo haiwezi ka develop action potential. We studied about the all or nothing law. Tulisema kwamba an action potential is either developed or will not develop at all. And regarding the all or nothing law, sometimes we may have different intensities of stimulus, the intensities by which the nerve is stimulated. So we may have the stimulus of this extent, and it may fail to develop action potential. We may have another stimulus of this extent, and it may fail to develop an action potential. We may have another stimulus of this extent. It may fail also to generate an action potential. So all of these, they are different levels of stimulation of the nerve cell, and they are below the action potential. So they are known as generator potential. It's just the localized depolarization, but does not form the action potential. Kwa unakuwa ni umeme ambao unakuwa haujafikia threshold value. Umeme ambao hujafikia value ya kutengeneza action potential. Hii generator potential, huu umeme, generator potential, ukiongezeka, ukafika threshold value, unatengeneza action potential. Kwa kifupi, generator potential ni umeme au depolarization ambao ni ndogo, haiwezi katengeneza action potential. That is, in short, regarding the generator, I mean regarding the generator potential. Ni umeme mdogo ambao hauwezi uka develop action potential. Unaona? Kwa tumesema generator potential results from the stimulus producing an increase in permeability of sensory cells towards sodium and potassium ions. Hiyo ni generator potential inatokana na the change in permeability. But second, the magnitude of generator potential varies with the intensity of stimulation. As I told you that the generator potential may have different intensities. You can recall this graph I said here. We may have this generator potential, another generator potential, another generator potential, but all of these may fail to produce an action potential. So a generator potential which will have a much higher intensity is the one which will actually succeed to produce an action potential. And number three, when the generator potential reaches threshold value, it develops an action potential. When a generator potential reaches a certain threshold value, it gives rise to an action potential. And finally, the frequency of the nerve impulse in the sensory axon is directly related to the intensity of stimulus. Frequency of the nerve impulse, not the speed of conduction. Remember, we said that the size of action potential remains the same regardless. The size of action potential remains the same regardless the intensity of stimulation of the nerve cell. Now let's move and let's discuss about the properties of receptors. Baadhi ya walimu wafundishi kuhusu mechanism of transduction na hata properties of receptors. Some of teachers, they don't teach, but I prefer to teach you because sometimes they appear in the exams, and it's better to be competent rather than to be less of knowledge. So the sensory cell with various threshold. This is the first characteristics of the receptors. Receptor, they consist of the sensory cells having various threshold. This enables the receptors to receive impulse ambayo itakuwa ina ukubwa mbalimbali. Na kuna seli nyingine ambazo ukubwa wake, threshold yake ni ndogo. Kwa hiyo kija weak stimuli, hizi seli zitai receive ile stimuli na zitai sense. Lakini kija the intense stimuli, hizi seli zitashindwa ku receive the stimulus vizuri. So the intense stimuli will require other cell having the higher threshold. So some sense organs such as the stretched septum and muscles are composed of many specialized cells which have range of threshold. If a cell has a low threshold, it responds to weak stimulus. As the strength of stimulus increases, the cell can respond by producing an increased number of impulses in the sensory neuron leaving the cell. A further increase in intensity of stimulus will excite sense cells with a higher threshold, and these two will produce frequency of nerve impulse, which is proportional to the intensity of stimulus. In this way, the range of receptor is extended. Yani manake, the ability of a receptor to receive different categories of stimulation with different intensities is increased, and thus receptor unakuwa na uwezo wa kupokea stimulus zenye intensity mbalimbali. The second characteristics of receptor is adaptation. Most of receptor initially respond to strong constant stimuli by producing frequency of impulse in the sensory neuron. Remember in the previous session I gave you an example of a machine. Kama umeshawahi kuwa mtoto mdogo ukawa unacheza jirani na mashine ya kusaga. Always kama ile mashine ilikuwa jirani ya barabara, the parents always warn us that don't play near the road. Kwa nini? Kwa sababu they didn't know about this concept of adaptation. But actually, kama ile mashine inakuwa na saga muda mrefu, that constant stimulation causes the nerve cell to become yani zile neurotransmitter zinaisha. Kwa zikiisha, ile tunaita kama we discussed that in part of synapse, I forget the specific terminology ambayo tunatumia. Lakini ninachozungumza hapa ni kwamba zile neurotransmitter kwenye synapse zinaisha. Zikiisha sasa, manake lazima nerve cell ichukue muda fulani upite, toka hapo ndio ifanyeje, toka hapo ndio ipitishe nerve nyingine. So always ubongo unacho sense ni badiliko. Yani kwa mfano umeingia kwenye room inapiga clock ta 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 ta, kama kuna badiliko kwenye ile stimulation, kuna baadaye ubongo utagino. So the frequency of these impulse gradually decline. When we receives the constant stimulation from the environment, the frequency of this impulse gradually decline, and this reduction in response with the time is called adaptation. The reduction in response with time is known as adaptation. For example, on entering a room, you may immediately notice a clock ticking, but after a while become unaware of its presence. The rate and extent of adaptation in receptor cell is related to its function, and there are two types of adaptation. We have the rapid adapting receptor and the slow adapting receptor. Rapid adapting receptor, sometimes they're known as phasic receptor, respond to change in stimuli level by producing a high frequency impulse at a moment when the stimulus is switched on or off. So when the stimulus is switched on or is switched off, pale ndipo inatengeneza intense stimuli. Lakini baada ya kuswitch vile, inakuwa inaendelea na maisha yake. So the response decreases if the stimulus is maintained. Response ina decrease. Kwa hiyo manake ni kama tukutengeneza stimuli ambayo inakuwa ni very intense, then when the stimulus is maintained, response ina decrease. They are rapid adapting receptor. They adapt rapidly. While others, they adapt slowly. The rate of decrease of the response is slowed, you know. So the response decreases if the stimulus is maintained. Example, the Pacinian corpuscle and other receptor concerned with the touch and detection of sudden changes act in this way. Kwa touch, let's say mtu akikutouch mara kwanza tap, akikutouch pale utaona nimeguswa. Lakini after time ule mguso unakuwa hauisi tena. Unaona? Our example Pacinian corpuscle ambayo inahusika na touch. So they register change in stimulus. Zenyewe zinaangalia change tu. They register only change. If there is no change, zina ignore. The second thing is the slowly adapting receptor, autonomic receptor. They keep firing as long as the stimulus is present. Unaona? They register a constant stimulus with a slow decreasing frequency of impulse. Example, the roofing nerve ending. Unaona? So zenyewe zina register stimulation, lakini also they register the a constant presence of that stimulation. If it is touch, then kama kule kutouch tu kuna kwa registered, and then the constant stimulation is also registered. And the example of the slowly adapting receptor, the roofing nerve ending. Unaona? Adaptation is thought to be related to decrease in the permeability of receptor membrane to ions due to a suitable stimulation. It's thought to be related to decrease in permeability of receptor membrane. Unaona? Permeability of receptor membrane. So we are talking of the postsynaptic membrane. Ndio ambayo inakuwa ina accept the transmitter substances. So also hapa permeability za hizi receptor ambazo zinakuwa zina generate nerve impulse. This progressively reduces the size and the duration of the generator potential, and when this falls below the threshold level, the sensory neuron ceases to fire. So if the permeability of this receptor membrane to ions is decreased, then it progressively reduces the size and duration of the generator potential, ambayo tushai discuss. And when the generator potential falls, that means even the probability of producing an action potential tend to decrease. The advantage of adaptation of sensors is that it provides animal with precise information about the change in the environment. Advantage of adaptation of sensors is that it provides animal with precise information about changes in the environment. So what the animals is provided with here is the changes in the environment, not everything which is taking place in the environment. The constant stimulation from the environment, like a clock which is ticking inside the room, they are ignored. But those which are the changes of the environment, they are the ones which are taken into consideration. At other times, the cells do not send signals, thus preventing overloading of the central nervous system with irrelevant and unmanageable information. This contributes to the overall efficiency and economy of the nervous system, and enable it to ignore unchanging background information and to concentrate on the monitoring aspect of the environment, which have mostly survival value. So adaptation is very important to help the central nervous system to ignore the informations which are not important and to deal with the informations which are only important for the survival of an organism. Number three is about the convergence and summation. As we discussed in the part of synapse, we said the synapses, they are responsible for the process of convergence. Convergence is the connection of one neuron, then it is connected to another neuron. It is connected to another neuron. How is this done? Is through the synapse. What it is done is that we may have four or five presynaptic neurons, and then we have only one postsynaptic neuron. So all of these three or five presynaptic neurons, they release their contents in this one postsynaptic neuron. So what is done is that these, all of these are five neurons, they release the neurotransmitter here. So what is done in this postsynaptic membrane is that the stimulation of these five neurons is collected together. Yani stimulation is in F5 inajumlishwa. Domanita it is summation. Inajumlishwa. Kwa hiyo inajumlishwa kinakuwa kitu kimoja, ndio maana ita summation. Convergence ni ile hali ya synapse 3, 4, 5 kufire kwenye post synaptic membrane moja. That is convergence. And the summation sasa ni ile summing up, kujumlisha kwa zile impacetto, così impacetto. A high degree of sensitivity is achieved in many sense organs by arrangement of sense cells and sensory neurons known as convergence. Convergence ni mpangilio, arrangement of the sensory cells. As I told you, the many presynaptic neurons, they release the neurotransmitter to one postsynaptic neuron. In such cases, several sense cells are connected to or they converge on a single sensory neuron. Several sense cells, that means several cells which combat the nerve impulse, they are connected to a single sensory neuron. These cells are characteristically small, are found in large number, are extremely sensitive to stimuli. Risk the effect of stimulation on a single one of these cells would not produce a response in a sensory neuron. The combined effect of simultaneous stimulation of several cells is cumulative. So effect ya several cell inakuwa cumulative, it is additive, yani inajumlishwa. This cumulative stimulatory effect produced in the sensory neuron is known as summation and is similar in function to the summative effect described before synapse. So summation, which is taking place here, it is partial summation. Actually, it is partial summation. Na kama ambavyo tuelezea summation katika synapse, pia huku huwa kuna a summation ambazo huwa zinatokea. A good example of convergence and summation is provided by the rod cells of the retina in the eye. Some of these cells are capable of detecting a single quantum of light. What is quantum? I hope you understand this from general chemistry. Baadhi cells za macho zina uwezo ku accept only single quantum of light, but the generator potential produced is inadequate to produce an actual potential in the neuron of optic nerve. However, several load cells ranging from 2 or 3 to several hundred are connected to a single bipolar neuron, and several of these bipolar neuron are connected to a single optic nerve fiber. You see, so there is convergence of the rod cell to the bipolar neuron, and again there is convergence of bipolar neuron to the optic nerve fiber. That means there will be a summation in level of bipolar neuron, and there will be summation in level of the optic nerve fiber. So the stimulation of at least 6 rods is required to produce an impulse in optic nerve fiber. At least 6 rods. I'm going to put only a single bipolar neuron in a more than 6 rods connected to it. So the increased visual sensitivity produced by this arrangement of rod is highly adapted to dim light vision. Kwa ndo maana rod cells zinatumika katika kuona kwenye dim light, yani kama usiku. Animals ambao ni nocturnal, wanafanya kazi zao usiku kama bundi na paka, wana high concentration of rod cell, yani the rods they are more numerous than the cones. Why? It's because they use the rods in night vision. These rods, which are numerous, they must do summation in order to enable these animals to look well even during night. So, and is well developed in nocturnal species such as owls, bundi, okay, anyway, but this is our friend bundi, owl, harja, and foxes. Foxes in mbwa fulani hivi, especially yuko mabara ya kizungu. All of these, hata paka, unasikia paka anaona vizuri usiku. Sio kwamba anaona vizuri usiku, hata mchana anaona, ila usiku ana rods nyingi. Kwa anakuwa anaona hata usiku kwa ubora tu. This high degree of sensitivity, however, is linked with a decreased in visual precision or acuity, as may be observed when attempting to read in poor light. So unapotaka kusoma kitu katika mwanga ambao ni poor, unashindwa kusoma kwa sababu gani? Less visual acuity. Pale unakuwa unatumia rod cells in a less visual acuity. Kini kama kuna a bright light, unakuwa unatumia cones ambazo zina high visual acuity. What is acuity and sensitivity? We discuss them tutakapokuwa tunasoma jicho. In human eye and that of many other species which are actively only during daylight, this problem is counteracted by the presence of cones, which with few exceptions do not show convergence or summation. What cones lose in sensitivity, they gain in acuity. as will be explained or described later. So because they don't have high visual sensitivity, but they have high visual acuity. What is visual acuity and what is visual sensitivity? We discuss it later. Another property of receptor is the spontaneous activity. Spontaneous activity. Tukisema kitu chochote ni spontaneous, maana yake hichi kitu kinafanya kazi bila kuhitaji energy ya nje. Tukisema reaction is spontaneous, maana yake reaction inaweza kuproceed even without the presence of the supply of external energy. We call it the reaction is spontaneous. Sasa kwa nini tunatumia neno spontaneous katika receptors? Kwa sababu sometimes receptors huwa zinatengeneza kama depolarization fulani hivi, ambayo ni depolarization ambayo impulse nyingine ikija inakuwa fired kirahisi sana. So some receptors produce nerve impulse in a sensory neuron in absence of stimulation. Zinatengeneza depolarization tayari, zinatengeneza nerve impulse in absence of stimulation. This system is not a meaningless as it might at first seem, as it has two important advantages. Sio kwamba haina kazi, ina kazi. Advantages zake ni mbili. Moja, it increases the sensitivity of the receptor by enabling it to make a response to a stimulus that would normally be too small to produce a response in sensory neuron. Kuna stimulus nyingine ambazo zingeonekana too slow to produce a response in sensory neuron. Lakini a spontaneous activity in allowing the stimulus to be detected and finally to produce a response. So any slight change in the intensity of stimulus will now add to the existing potential in the receptor and produce a change in the frequency of impulse along the sensory neuron. Lakini mbili, the direction of change in the stimulus can be registered by this system. Direction of change in the stimulus can be registered by this system as increase by this system as an increase or decrease in the frequency of the response in the sensory neuron. Kwa hiyo direction ya change inaweza kuwa detected kama ni increase au decrease. Maanake kama stimulus yetu ni decrease, itapunguza kile ambacho kishakuwepo tayari. For example, infrared receptor in pits in the face of the rattlesnake, which act as direction finders in location prey and predators, show spontaneous activity and are able to discriminate increase or decrease in temperature of 0.1 degrees Celsius. Zinawezo kudifferentiate increase or decrease in temperature yop. Finally, we have the feedback control of receptor. The feedback control of receptor. Receptors zote huwa zinakuwa zina feedback control. Yani manake huwa zinakuwa controlled kwamba umepeleka impulse, ile impulse kishafanyao kazi, kuna kuko na taarifa inarudi inakwambia basi sasa tumeshasikia. Unaona? So feedback control is very important for all receptors in order to maintain their activity. So the threshold value of some sense organ can be raised or lowered by efferent or outer impulses from the central nervous system. So the threshold of these sense organ, it can be raised or it can be lowered. This reset the sensitivity of the receptor to respond to different ranges of stimulus intensity. In many cases, the mechanism of control involves feedback from the receptor, which produces changes in the accessory structure enabling the receptor cell to function over a new range. This occurs, for example, in the iris of the eye, ambayo kuna koko na a feedback control inayosoma sahivi iris I direct or I contract, ili finally iweze kufanya kazi kama inavyotakiwa. This marks the end of our discussion regarding the introduction to receptors. Tumesoma receptors na kategori zake, tumesoma hapo mechanism of transduction pamoja na features or properties of receptor. Katika kipindi kijacho tutaanza jicho. Hapa katika receptor tuta discuss jicho pamoja na sikio. For our level, we discuss about the eye and the ear. Lakini it is somehow ndefu, ni kidogo ni ndefu, kwa hiyo tuta discuss vitu for your advantage. Thank you, and let you wish you nice studies.